Restorative design is an interesting workshop. It grew out of a concept that Bob Winter and I had when we were doing live patient courses here at the center. When we first moved here and joined the Scottsdale Center, they already had a course in place for doing live patient anterior dentistry. We absorbed that. We since have discontinued it because it was very difficult to do. And what Bob and I realized right up front was that with no classes planned ahead of that specifically to look at preparation design, we spent a lot of our time trying to figure out exactly what we should be doing with every patient, because preparation design is highly individualized to make the outcome that you desire. So what Bob did, and Bob really deserves the credit for this because he put the idea together as a course, he created models where we have teeth that simulate real teeth. They're bilayered, which means they have enamel and dentin. The neat thing is they're made of composite. The outer composite is harder. When you hit the inner one, it's like hitting dentin. It's softer. It really is noticeable. They very closely mimic natural teeth in that the enamel is the same thickness you'd find in a natural tooth. And what we do is now go in and do ideal preparations on those teeth for specific materials and specific designs of preparations. There's 28 potential restorations that somebody can do while they're in the workshop. Most of our participants do at least 24. Many different designs, from full coverage, you know, all the way through to a simple two-surface inlay. Although most of our time is spent on partial coverage restorations, because that is where every prep is unique.
Some of the key elements that you take away from restorative design is a clear concept of how to prepare teeth before you begin to prepare the teeth. And you have a mindset of what materials you're going to use to restore the case. Yes, you may have an interaction with a technician because the technician may give some input on what techniques and materials they can handle best. But in that case, you then may have to alter your preparation to fit into what works with the technician or the team member creating a restoration. So the key concepts are outcome-based preparation design, how aesthetics, structure of teeth and function of teeth impact preparation design. Those are the key elements that you'll take away from the course.
The most interesting thing for me that came out of restorative design is that we got the most immediate and the most enthusiastic feedback of any workshop at any place that I've ever been involved with. And what I heard from people was, this was something that I plugged in the minute I sat down in my chair when I got home. It changed how I prepare teeth. It changed how I think about what I should be looking for. It changed my system. And when I changed my system, I became more efficient. And when I became more efficient, at the same time, I became better. People tell us their laboratory technicians have sent them notes or called them. And one person actually sent us a copy of a letter where the technician said, "I have no idea where you went or what you did. Your work was always extraordinary. Now it is over the top." So what's been fun for both Bob and I in that is that it's fun to have something that people go home and immediately they realize how great it was in value for them. What they could take home and change what they do and feel better about what they're doing.
So the course library at Spear is really, it's an amazing resource that I've implemented from the very beginning. So if I go to a workshop and I learn techniques, sometimes it may be many months. It'll be months before I'm able to implement what I learned, and it's so convenient to have the, to be able to go back to the library and find a technique that I was taught here and then reinforce what I learned and then be able to apply it to a patient.